us who your gown's by?
It's LSO Designs, Linda Stokes.
Okay. Can you tell us what your upcoming projects are?
Yes, I'm going to be doing a PBS special with Marvin Hamlisch. I'm doing it in a couple of weeks from now, and we're going to be filming it in St. Louis, and it's going to be airing in August. It's called Marvin Hamlisch, The 70s, The Way We Were.
Oh, well, that sounds like a great project.
Yes.
Is there a website that's dedicated to it?
Well, it's on my website. It's www.fridapayne.com. So you can check it out on my website.
Okay, and who are you rooting for Best Picture tonight?
I would say, you know, I like Avatar, and I also saw Hurt Locker, and I do agree with the overwhelming consensus of opinion is that Hurt Locker should win. And I think so. I mean, I wouldn't be hurt if Avatar doesn't win, but I enjoyed Avatar as well.
There are so many pictures this year that you could pick from, like Inglourious Basterds, too.
I saw that, yeah.
If you could pick the greatest movie of all time, which one would you pick?
Of all time. That's a hard... But I tell you what, I like The Color Purple.
Okay. Oh.
I like The Color Purple.
Oh, that was a wonderful film. My uncle worked on that.
It should have won Best Picture the year it was nominated, but it didn't. And I disagree with the choice that did win, but that doesn't mean anything.
Well, do you know Oprah Winfrey?
I've met Oprah Winfrey. Everybody knows Oprah Winfrey.
Yeah. I know. Well, you would, though, because you're a star.
I don't know her personally. I don't know her personally.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering because, I mean, you liked The Color Purple, so you just
like
the movie.
I like her mentor, Quincy Jones. Quincy, and I started out with, I was one of Quincy's first protégés. I started out when I was 18 years old, I sang with his big band.
Oh, well, tell us about that. How did you get discovered by Quincy?
I was in New York at, I was like around 18, 18 and a half, 19, living in New York. I'd just come from Detroit. That's where my hometown. And I met Quincy, and he had his big band at that time, and he was performing at a club on the east side of New York called Basin Street East. And so we met at one of these after hours breakfast places, and then I happened to meet him at a club, a little small piano bar, and he asked me to sing, and I sang. And so 2 weeks later, he calls me up and he asked me would I like to work with him and Billy Eckstein and his big band at the Apollo Theater with Red Fox and Coles and Atkins. And I said, yes.
I know.
You know, so I got to work with him. And I worked with him we worked two or three times. We did a whole tour together.
And then what did you do after that, after you started working with Quincy?
Oh, my God, I did so many things. I worked with Sammy Davis Jr. I worked with Bill Cosby. I've had two gold records, Band of Gold.
And
All That's Left is a Band, and Bring the Boys Home. And I was recently talking about Quincy, things go around and come around. He invited me to be on the We Are the World remake video for Haiti. So I'm in that. I'm standing right next to Barbara Streisand. And also, I did the Montreux Jazz Festival with him. The year was 2008. And I did it in Montreux, Switzerland. So I did that as well.
You're part of the We Are the World song is my favorite. I knew it was you.
Yeah.
Okay, you have a fantastic voice. I'm such a big fan of yours.
Thank you,
thank you very much for stopping.
Thank you. Okay. God bless.